little more. Woo. Not bad for losing an oar.
That was a race. That was a race. Well, it wasn't pretty, but it was a race.
I'm taking water. Come on, dude.
Attention.
What is going on, rowing community? My name is Justin Best. It's been a while. We got a lot of catching up to do, and I have a pretty exciting video for you today, in my opinion, but maybe not. I don't know. We'll see how this actually plays out. I got my notes on things that I want to talk about. I'm just going to recap 2021 really quick, kind of talk about things that are happening, and then kind of talk about going forward. I had wanted to make more videos, and I truly did. And I think that after the games, I had filmed stuff to upload, and then life just catches up with you. I had to get a new job, and I did get a new job, and that just took a lot of time. And I was really enjoying time with family, and you know, hanging around my hometown in Kennett Square, Pennsylvania.
Your name is now Pierre. Hello, Pierre the Goat. I have nothing for you, but I'm sure you want something.
Around sometime in September, got a text message about getting back to some training out in California, and I flew out there to do that, and I hurt my back.
I broke my back.
You
my
broke
back is broken.
Or what portion?
Spinal.
So that was unfortunate, but I've been working to try and get it better. Apologies for this angle. I left my tripod that I usually use at my home in Pennsylvania. So right now, this stack of books is what we're working with here. Anyways, back to September. So I hurt my back. It was just like this L4 niggling pain.
Spinal.
Continued to try and get back into some fitness, trying to do some lifting, trying to get stronger. I went to the head of the Charles where I raced the double, which was actually a lot of fun. The entire weekend was a great time. We stayed in an Airbnb right by Fenway Park, which was such a cool experience because I don't think I've ever actually stayed at head of the Charles like that close to the regatta venue. So like we got there my first day that I went, I ran the entire course of the Charles because our boat wasn't there and I wasn't sure about erging or something. So that was such a good time. And the race was interesting, and I'll put the clip, the infamous clip from the race. I put a GoPro in the stern and you'll see the rest.
And you may row. Have a great race.
Thank you.
But after that, it was such a great time. I got to meet a ton of awesome people at the US rowing booth and sign some autographs with other Olympians, which I thought was really cool. Everyone was so awesome, and the rowing community really popped off for Head of the Charles 2021. There was a lot more energy than I had noticed in the past few Head of the Charles, and it was an absolute blast because that was kind of like the biggest rowing event that was post-COVID, but it's kind of that similar back to normal. It was really cool to be able to have that massive event and see all those thousands of spectators and parents and junior crews and like really high-end crews. And it was overall a great trip. And Head of the Schuylkill was also a really interesting regatta. I remember I borrowed a boat from Vesper, and at a certain point during my warm-up, I was hydroplaning so much the skeg of my single was completely out of the water.
Because I was inverted.
And the conditions were rough on the day of racing. I ended up announcing some broadcasting for the following day, and the day that I was actually racing at Head of the Schuylkill, which I thought was a lot of fun. Post Head of the Schuylkill, I came back to California for a little bit, and then Thanksgiving rolled by, you know, Christmas and New Year's rolled by, and now I'm back out in Oakland for the foreseeable future. In other news, U.S. Rowing has blown up the training centers. No, that's not a fair way to say that. U.S. Rowing has disbanded the training centers at this point, until they don't. So what that means is there used to be a training center where athletes that were trying to compete for the straight four and the eight and any other various boats, it depended year to year what came out of the actual training center. They were centralized locations with a consistent head coach and facilities. Those are no longer a thing. So the women's one was based in New Jersey and the men's one was based here in Oakland. And at this point, U.S. Rowing disbanded them after taking in a bunch of athlete feedback, and they decided, okay, you know what, we'll go back to a clubs-based system. So with that, the creation of California Rowing Club has happened again. It's helmed by Mike Tatey and the assistant coach Skip Kill, and we're just rolling again. Like, things haven't changed. So doing a lot of training out here in Oakland, in the Bay Area. And with that, the new way of selecting, and at the time of recording this video, I don't know what is confirmed and what's not, because there's also the hiring of the chief high performance director, Yosi. He will now have an input on what the selection procedures were prior to him getting hired, which could be kind of confusing. But the way I read it at this point, until a new thing has been changed, is there are trials for the single and then speed orders for the other boat classes that get you invited to selection camps. So if you do well in the speed orders and you do well in the erg, you get invited to these shorter selection camps. Selection camp prior to this could have lasted 3 or 4 months. These ones seem like they're gonna last 1 to 2 weeks. But I'm just kind of speculating at this point because nothing's been confirmed by U.S. Rowing. And anytime it seems like they confirm something, they backtrack on it.
Emotional damage!
Classic U.S. Rowing. Anyways, so with that, the next goal of mine is to compete at the trials in Sarasota, Florida, in the single or potentially a pair. Still not sure yet. It's a few months away at this point and still some time to make those decisions and really button down exactly what we'll be doing. After the trials and speed orders, the next step would to be traveling to Europe for World Cups or Henley. At this point, again, don't have anything really confirmed by anyone. So there could be a potential World Cup 2 in Poznan, Poland, followed by a trip to Henley the following week. But that would be later on in the summer, in June, I want to say. I'll put the date of World Cup 2 on this here. I don't think that there would be the boats that would race at the World Championships. The World Championships this year is late September. It's very late compared to the other World Championships in the years past. Usually that'll happen somewhere in August. This is very late September. And that is in Řečice, the Czech Republic. So all eyes are set towards that. And at this point, it's going through the process to becoming a part of the team to be able to race there. Just because you made the team in the past does not necessarily you will make the team in the future. So with that, we're training really hard at California Rowing Club. We're trying to find different combinations that work, you know, testing sculling, testing sweeping, because at the end of the day, if it's a fast boat, that's what you want to race in. So I've never actually sculled internationally. I've done plenty of sculling, like head races. I haven't done a sculling 2K side-by-side race since like my senior year of high school. So I think lots of options at this point. And we have a good group of guys at the California Rowing Club. And I think like we have a really solid base to put out some fast boats, whether it's a quad, a double, straight four, a pair. I'm confident that we'll be able to put out some good combinations that can do well at the speed orders, do well at the trials, and then do well internationally at the different World Cups that we could potentially race at. I know that there's a lot of things up in the air in terms of these systems to get to the World Championships, but I'm confident in the work that we're doing and the guys that we have here. I know we have the talent and I know we have the drive, so it's just putting the pieces together and being able to show up when the results matter. That being said, doing the work, I ended up PRing on my 6K, which was so great after not having done an erg test in over a year. It was a good feeling. A lot of energy in the room when we did it. A bunch of the guys crushed it. So that was pretty cool. I know we'll have to do 2Ks coming up. Not sure if we're gonna do any more 6Ks. I think that's kind of just like up to our coaches at this point. If they do prescribe a 6K, I wouldn't mind. I think I could do well again on that, but 2K, I'm just gonna put it out there. I would like to break 550. 550 is the goal. Currently I'm at a 552 and that's about a year and a half old at this point. So hopefully I can break 550 and that would be really exciting. But with that, I want to do more filming. So hopefully be able to create some more videos about random rowing things and actually live up to what I'm trying to do with this channel, which I haven't been doing a great job of, but I want to do better. And that's what the point of the new year is, to do better than last year. But yeah, really excited to attack the new year, new goals, and trying to do things better than I did last year. And with that, try and get better results than I did last year. It's a short turnaround between now and Paris. It's already about 2 years, to be honest. If you realistically look at the selection schedule and when you should be peaking towards the games, like at this point, it's just about those 2 years, and I'm gonna do everything that I can in my power to put myself in the optimal position to make the team again in Paris, and then obviously perform at the Olympics. That's enough about me. If you have watched through this video at this point, leave a comment down below what you're looking forward to in 2022, rowing or anything else wise. I would love to see it. Thank you for subscribing to the channel over the past few months. I've seen a few more subscriptions. That's always a good thing. I think I'm above 100 now, which is really encouraging. That's all from me. So if you like this video and you want to see more videos like this or anything else, please leave a comment, like, and then also subscribe. I'm going to make it my commitment that there's not going to be this big gap between my last upload and the next upload. I'm going to hold myself accountable for that. Anyways, thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you in the next one.